Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. You've probably seen a lot of filmmakers creating these little montage sequences with lots of cool seamless transitions, right? And I've made tutorials on seamless transition packs, but how do you make them yourselves without using plugins? And that's what I'm gonna show you in this video. We're gonna focus on one type of transition, the swish pan, or what people call the whip pan, just using three different effects inside of After Effects. And better yet, to save you time, you can save it as your own template. So you can use this template over and over again, just replace your footage and you have your whip pans. So I've included the project files in the description box below, and you can follow along step by step. Also, shout out to Envato Elements for sponsoring this video. You can get 70% off your first month of unlimited creative assets, and I'll tell you more about Elements later on in the video. But for now, let's go ahead and jump into After Effects and get started. So here I have three motorcycle shots in my composition, and there's just a basic, simple cut between them. But let's add some dynamism by creating our own swish pans or whip pans from scratch. So to make our first swish pan between the first two clips here, we need to first create an adjustment layer. So go up to layer and select new and then adjustment layer. And let's drag this adjustment layer down on top of shot 2 and 1. Next, what we need to do is apply a distort effect. So from effect and presets, search for transform, and it's underneath the distort folder, and just drag and drop this onto the adjustment layer. And now we need to keyframe the position in the direction we want this whip pan to be. So if you want it to go from left to right, we can keyframe the horizontal position. If we want it to go up and down, we can keyframe the vertical position. So in this case, let's do the down movement. So just select a starting point here. Make sure that you have the adjustment layer selected. From effect controls, select the stopwatch to begin animating the position. And from here, we can move to the ending point of our transition. Let's say around here. This is where we can then move the vertical position. If I click and pull it down, you can see how it starts to move down. You can also enter in any value that you want. Let's say we want it to be around 6,000. Now, if we select the adjustment layer and hit U on the keyboard, this will reveal the keyframes. So now it'll just be a basic movement up and down. And the speed of this is controlled by the value of the position. So if you ever want to change the speed for it to be a little bit slower, let's say, you can right click, edit value. And then because we're using the vertical, we're going to edit the Y coordinates here. So if we wanted to make this just 3000, you can see that it's a bit slower and it actually doesn't fully go off the frame. So in this case, we want it to be faster, and let's edit value and let's bring this back up to around 6000 again. So now we have our two points and we want to make it so it's a little bit smoother from the get-go. So let's go ahead and select these two keyframes and let's make these easy ease keyframes so it's a little bit smoother. And there we go, it's smoother. But now we need to create repetition. So as this slides down, there'll be repeated frames of this same video. So to do that, we're going to select the adjustment layer and from effect and presets, search for CC repeat tile. Some people call it repeat tile or rep tile. And all you have to do is just drag and drop this on the adjustment layer or double click to apply it. And from here, we want to move to the last keyframe. And to bring the footage back up so it's in frame, we need to use the expand up parameter here. So as I click and drag to the right, you see nothing happens because we have to keep clicking and moving. It's actually easier just to type in the number here, but you can see as I click and scroll to the right, it starts to reveal the footage here, right? And you can see here, this is the repeating line. So as I scrub through, you can see that the footage is repeating itself, which is already a pretty cool effect as is. But because we want it to end where this second shot is fully in frame, we need to make some adjustments here. So this is where we can go back up to position and we can position this so that way it'll be fully in the frame at this last point.
So just like that. So now if we play it back, you can see that it's a nice smooth sliding transition. And from here you can say, oh, well, it already looks pretty good. You could actually use this as its own transition. But if you want it to have more of that whip pan swishing look, you need to add some motion blur. So to add motion blur here, you're going to select enable motion blur and then select motion blur for the adjustment layer. So when we select that, now let's play this back. So you can see it has a little bit more blur on it, but there are some black lines here. If you're trying to create a film strip slide effect, you may want to keep these black lines in between because it kind of looks like a film strip. But if you want to get rid of them, this is where we need to pre-compose these layers. So hold shift and select shot one. So you have adjustment layer one, shot two, and shot three all selected. Then right click and select pre-compose. And we can call this whip pan down, hit okay. And now you can see it's its own comp. Double click to open it up and you can see all the layers are in this new comp. And what we need to do to get rid of this black line is actually select these two shots, Command C or Control C on a PC to copy it, then go to transitions and hit Command V to paste. And then we just need to drag these layers down below this composition. And now you can see it filled in the black lines with the footage beneath it. So let's just play this back to see how it looks. All right, it looks a little bit better, but you can see that the footage beneath doesn't have any blur on it. So to fix that, we need to fake it. We need to go up to Effect Controls and search for Gaussian Blur and drag and drop it on the first shot. And if we increase this, you can see it just kind of makes it look generally blurry. But because the position is changing vertically, we just want the blur dimensions to be vertical. And that makes it a little bit more realistic, but let's keep increasing it. Let's say around 150. I think that looks pretty good. You can play around with this value until it looks right. Even 167 is better. So then you can just copy this effect by hitting Command C or Control C on a PC, go to shot number two and Command V to paste it. So now it looks a little bit more realistic. So let's play it back. And so that is the whip pan down. What if you want it to be left to right? So let's move on to this next transition between this shot of him riding the motorcycle, it's kind of a medium shot, to this wider shot. So once again, let's go up to layer, let's go to new adjustment layer. And let's bring this adjustment layer up to the very top. And this is where we need to duplicate shot number two and bring it up because it's also involved in this next transition that we need to pre-compose as well. So just go up to edit and duplicate. And this is where we're gonna drag this layer up so it's also a part of this one. But because we added the Gaussian blur or the Gaussian blur, you need to delete this now and hit delete. And then also, we want to move this over so it's only a part of this next transition. So that way it's not affecting this transition at all. So we can move this layer just around here. Okay, so now from adjustment layer two, we can once again go up to effects and presets and search for transform. And let's drag and drop this onto the adjustment layer. And from here, we need to choose our starting point. Let's say we want it to start here, then select the stopwatch next to position. And let's move where we want the transition to end, let's say around here. And because we want it to go off to the right, this is where we're gonna move it off to the right. And once again, you can choose your speed by changing this value. Let's say we want it to be 10,000, hit return. And then from this layer, select U on your keyboard to reveal the keyframes. And now you can see it just pushed off to the right. And to make the keyframes more smooth, just lasso and select them. Right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease, or press F9 on your keyboard. So now it's more smooth. The next step is to add the repeat tile or the reptile effect. So let's go to the last keyframe. Go up to effects and presets, CC repeat tile. There it is, double click to apply it. And from here, we want to expand left because we want this footage to be revealed. We won't actually see anything until we get closer up to 5,000, but we need to keep pushing this over until it fills up the frame. And you can see that the repeating line is here, and we need to adjust the position now so this line is just off frame. So we need to push this over just slightly until we get the full frame in view. And there we go. So now once again, here is the shot. Now we need to add the motion blur. So once again, select motion blur here. And this is what it looks like. And now we need to pre-compose like we did before. So let's collapse this layer and let's select this adjustment layer and hit shift and select shot 2 and then right click and pre-compose. And let's call this whip pan right and hit okay. Once again, we need to double click to open this up and copy these two layers here. Hit Command C or Control C on a Mac, go back to the transitions layer, hit Command V or Control V to paste, and then just move these two shots beneath the whip pan right. And just like before, we want to add the Gaussian blur. So we can go to shot number 1, we can copy the Gaussian blur that we applied before by hitting Command C, go to this first clip here, and then go up to Effect Controls and hit Command V. But this time, because it's side to side movement, we want it to be horizontal. And let's go ahead and copy this one more time, Command C or Control C. Go to the shot number 3, this one right here, and see how it's not blurred behind this pre-composition. So when we go to Effect Controls and paste it, Command V, you can see it just looks a lot more seamless. So here's the final result here, and it looks pretty awesome. And you can use this technique in any direction that you want. You can even change the horizontal and the vertical position to make it go off into a corner of the screen, depending on whichever direction that you want. And this effect can be really cool to add to any montage sequences that you are doing. Now, let's say you wanted to save this as a template. So you could just go up to File and Save As. And when you open it up, let's say you wanted to replace any of the footage, you can actually go and select whatever shot you want to replace, right click, and reveal layer source in project. And then from here, from the project panel, you can right click and you can replace the footage with a different file. So that way you can then use whatever footage you want in this template. So you would just go through all the shots that you have here, shot number 2, you would replace the footage, shot number 3, replace the footage, and that's how you can, you know, use this template over and over again, and then you just go up to File and Save As a different project. So let's say you want to pull this entire sequence into Premiere Pro. What you can do is take this transitions composition, which has all three of them in here, and you can pull After Effects over, and when you have Premiere Pro open, you can just drag and drop this transitions into the project panel here, and it will pull it in as its own comp that's dynamically linked. And you can right click and create a new sequence from the clip. And now we'll have the sequence here in Premiere Pro that you can then render out and add to your video. And that's all there is to it.
So if this tutorial helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. It helps me know if you want more tutorials like this one on the channel, and be sure to hit that little notification bell so you're notified when I publish more tips so you keep up to date on all the cool new trends going on in the filmmaking world. And now I want to tell you a little bit about today's sponsor, Envato Elements. So I'm sure that you guys have heard of Envato Market before. It's where you can go to places like Video Hive to buy one-off templates or stock video clips that you can use in single videos. And the downside about this is that you have to pay each time you want to get a new license. So if it costs $40 for a template, if you want to use it in another video, you have to pay another $40. So that gets expensive. But the Envato team reached out to me and they said, hey, we've made this new platform called Envato Elements, where you can pay a monthly subscription to get an unlimited number of assets. So stock video, templates, background music. And at first I was kind of skeptical because, you know, there's so many different subscription-based services on the platform. So what sets Envato Elements apart? Well, I tried it out and I was really surprised at how useful it was to my workflow. If I needed a new logo opener, which I recently changed to, I used a template from Envato Elements. If I need some quirky background music track, I just search their library and find it there. And talking about transitions, they have tons of transitions that you can use. So if you don't want to create your own transition packs from scratch, you can download a whole seamless transitions pack or modern transitions, light leaks, glitches, wipes, colorful stripe transitions. They really have anything that you need. And I partnered up with Elements because I felt like the product was so great. They set up a 70% off link that you guys can use so you can try it out for 70% off your first month and let me know what you think of it. I think it's a great deal because it's less than $10 with my discount. So if you really want to give it a spin to see if it's worth the money each month, definitely try it out. And I've linked to a collection of all of my favorite assets that I use with Elements in my description box below so you can see which ones I use in my own YouTube videos. So yeah, that's it for this video. And thanks so much for watching, and thanks to Elements for sponsoring, and I'll see you next time. Bye.